Muhammad Sharik, Indian, saying, don't compel us to invite Lashkar-e-Taiba to India. Who is us?
Gaurav Sahib, first and foremost, you know, Tariq Fateh Sahib very humbly has not read the Indian constitution. The constitution, the beautiful constitution of my country, allows me to be a Sayyid Asad Abbas and gives me the freedom of
speech. I know that.
Yes, but it does not. I'm sure the Indian constitution, I am sorry, does the Indian constitution permit Muhammad Sharif to say, don't compel us to invite Lashkar-e-Taiba to India?
Allow me to finish my point. Now, coming straight at the Shari and so on and so forth. Time and again, I've made this statement, be it any respective political party, when it comes to dealing with terrorism, be it a Congress, BJP or a JDS of my current state of Karnataka, must come together in one force and deal with these terrorists who are bringing
it's
a bad day.
Terrorism.
Let me tell you, Tariq Fateh, the only religion of a terrorism.
Terrorist
is terrorism.
This is ideology.
And, Islamophobe might call it there. Huh? But let me tell
this
you, Derek,
come on. Don't divert us to Islamophobia. You are the one, Sayyid Abbas, who is linking terrorism and Islam then. We are not, nobody's against Islam. People are against terrorists. Please do not, Imran Khan may call this Islamophobia because Imran Khan is in the dim. I am sure Sayyid Abbas is not in the dim. This is
absolutely
not Islamophobia.
Not,
this has got nothing to do with Islamophobia. Temur,
okay,
the
now,
children
allow
of
me to
Temur
complete
might
point.
Believe
that.
But I'm a Hindustani.
With all humility, allow me to complete my point. Respected sir, there are
sir, complete your point, but do not digress from the issue. I am sorry. Sayyid Abbas, with due respect, sir, with due respect, permit me. My question to you was very specific. Muhammad Sharik, Indian, writes graffiti on the wall, don't compel us to invite Lashkar-e-Taiba to India. Sir, who is this us? Who in India dares to invite Lashkar-e-Taiba to India? Who is this us?
First and foremost, Gaurav Sahib, Sharik or any of his likes are nothing but terrorists. And us is also terrorists. Be it the ISIS, be it the Lashkar-e-Taiba, be it any of their Jamaat, are nothing but these are the people who have misinterpreted everything. The fact we need to address them as terrorists and the belonging of a terrorist is terrorism. And also as a matter of fact, I agree with one point with you and Tariq Fateh is, every Indian Muslim, true to its blood, must come out and condemn such terrorists who are spoiling the name of the religion. The fact of the matter we need to understand is that the misinterpretation that comes through, those like you mentioned about Imran Khan, Imran Khan is the biggest terror sympathizer and apologist out there. Imran Khan, in our words, is a munafik. He cares about Indian Muslim, but he dares not speak a word about Uyghur Muslims of China.
But
this
sir,
shows his hypocrisy.
But sir, but it's the same Islamophobia. Terminology, dekho na sir. Terminology, dekho na. Imran Khan, the moment you talk about terror, Imran Khan says Islamophobia. The moment I talk about terror, you said Islamophobia. But Tariq Fateh, the bigger concern is, who is this us? Terrorists in Kashmir wanted some pan-Islamic caliphate. They wanted some Islamic state. And sir, you've written a book on it. Is it the same ideology that's running deeper, whether it's Kashmir, Kerala or Karnataka?
Not just there, sir. This is running in Egypt. This is running in United States of America, Canada, France, Germany and in England. Who are the people who have started identifying that England is being drowned by RSS? Where did that come from? The Leicester riots took place. Who did that? People are being fooled by this notion that we have to be against terrorism. But they will never accept the fact that we have to stop praying against the kuffar and ask for jihad when we go to pray on a Friday prayer. There has to be some mullahs charged with hate literature, just like this fellow who's gone to Qatar.
But unfortunately, he's guest of honor. He's guest of honor. He's wanted for terror in Bangladesh. He's wanted for hate speeches in India. And he's guest of honor in Qatar. Just because Qatar has money, it's a terror preacher is acceptable. But Sayyid Abbas, more than just isolated cases.
He's respected in the Indian Muslim community.
More than isolated cases.
He's considered a scholar. They call him doctor.